الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness, there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and His messenger. O Allah, let Your prayer, Your peace and blessing be upon Your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, we still with the ethics of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a few verses at the end of Surah Al-Baqarah that we are encouraged to recite in the morning and the evening. And this few verses is mainly about al-istighfar, about that you make istighfar all the time, and how the believers make istighfar, and what's the benefits of this istighfar. This verses at the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا وفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion, the believers, they believed, indeed they believed in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them. They sent to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to believe in the angels, and to believe in the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the people, the Torah, the real Torah, the real angel. The Bible, and also and they believe in the previous messengers that they came to humanity to guide them to the right path. We don't differentiate between the prophets. All the prophets, we call for the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we believe in all of them. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the believers, they said, we heard it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we believed and we obey. And ask for forgiveness. O Allah, forgive us our return to you. When you believe that we're going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, and that's what we should do all the time. Now, when you realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easier in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam nation, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. And the many previous nations, they were asked to do things heavier and even harder than what we have now. But everything is easy on us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made everything is easy on us. And whatever, even if we forget, we are not reliable for what we forget. Even if we made the mistakes, we have options and we have the chance to repent and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. So what else you need? You need, if you made mistakes, go ahead, repent and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. If you forget, even if you, for instance, if you are fasting and you ate while you are fasting, you don't remember, your fast is still valid. And you continue on, and even means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the food and drink to, as long as you forget that. So everything is easy on us. And even So we pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will not be responsible for things that we cannot afford. Could you imagine look at what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was in the Isra wal Mi'raj, when he first it was 50 prayers on us. Could you imagine that you do 50 prayers a day? And then when he reached Prophet Musa alayhi salam, this is Prophet Musa alayhi salam, we owe him all this, the reduction of all these prayers from 50 to 5. But still we get the reward of 50. So you could imagine how much effort that you're going to do when you are responsible of doing, and this is the prayer is obligatory, you have to do it. And if you have to pray 50 times a day, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy on us through Prophet Musa, that he advised Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go back and ask for reduction of all these prayers until came 5 in action, but 50 in their words. And not only that, and out of all this, so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to have something heavier on us that we cannot afford, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is going to have all these blessings for us, and He will have us to have victory on the disbelievers. So keep in mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on your side, just to follow His path, and you will find His path is you will be content. You will reach the paradise through that, but not the devils, not the wrong path. So we keep that in mind. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us in His right path all the time. In another verses that which is the Al-Imran, verse 146 to 148, وَكَأَيِّن مِّن نَّبِيٍّ قَاتَلَ مَعَهُ رِبِّيُّونَ كَثِيرٌ فَمَا وَهَنُوا لِمَا أَصَابَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَمَا ضَعَفُوا وَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. All the previous prophets and their companions, they never felt anything wrong with what they have to do. They kept patient. Whatever in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they followed the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were not weak, they were strong, because they believed strongly in what they have done, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love the patient people. If you are patient with the way in your way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you unlimited, will reward you with something that you don't know. And because بغير حساب, this means that we cannot put something that we know about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only knows what the reward that we're going to get. What did he say? وَمَا كَانَ قَوْلُهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا. Always, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا. Oh Allah, forgive us our sins. And forgive us because as human, we are not perfect. Whatever we do, we always keep in mind that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا. We may do something that we exceed our limits, but we return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for forgiveness. And وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَمَنَا. Make our foot strong and steady in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we don't go right or left. We stay in the right path straight. وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. That's what you always pray, supplicate. Supplication is the key for success in this life and the afterlife. What's the reward? فَأَتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ ثَوَابَ الدُّنْيَا وَحُسْنَ ثَوَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. The results out of all this, when you supplicate, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the rewards in this life and in the afterlife. ثَوَابَ الدُّنْيَا, that you're going to live the life according to the most important, according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands. وَحُسْنُ ثَوَابِ الْآخِرَةِ, it is the paradise that you're going to receive. Not only that, you see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the most, the highest level of rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Because when you do that, when you follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala path, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you, because you're going to reach one of the highest levels with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala way, and this is what we seek, this is what we should work on. And also, this is when the believers supplicate all the time, then what one of the verse here in Surah Al-Imran 193, رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمَعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا. Look, what when you sit and just think about your life and think about what you believe in and think about what you do and say, oh Allah, I believe in what you sent through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that you know God except you. You are the one. And I believe in the messengerhood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we just repeat that and believe in the messengerhood of all the prophets, the previous, the true books of you. And I believe in the angels, I believe in the heaven, and I believe in the hellfire, and I believe in all this. When you testify that over and over, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ. So, and always ask Allah Ta'ala for forgiveness from your sins and all the, whatever wrong you've done. وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ. That's the most important thing, is your end. Some people, they live their life, good life, but unfortunately they end it wrong. And some people, they live their life wrong, and this destined Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have their end right. So it depends on the end, how you're going to end in this life. So that you, when you come to the end, the last words of you to say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. That's the most important thing. To die with the believers, to die with the in the right path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you, that you don't to die in the wrong doings. Because when you die in the wrong doings, you're going to be resurrected in the wrong doings. But when you die in the prayer, as a prayer, or making sujood, or doing something good, you're going to be resurrected, and that's going to make you to live in the paradise forever. So أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله عز وجل أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. The father of humanity, Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he put him in the paradise and asked him not to eat from certain tree. But the devil, Shaitan, made him to eat from it. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrated this in the Quran al-Kareem, it shows how examples that when you do wrongdoings, immediately repent. Immediately ask for forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the forgiveness. Ya Adam, اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة فكلا من حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam and his wife, Hawa, to live in the paradise. But eat from wherever, all what's in the paradise, eat from except one tree. Because you're going to be doing wrong when you do that. And what happened? The devil came and convinced him to eat from it. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that that Adam, you did wrong and it says the shaitan is your enemy. And immediately what Adam and Eve said, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That's the response. That's different than the response of the devil himself. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him about that he did wrong when did not obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prostrating to Adam, he challenged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and told him, you created me from the fire and you created him from the dust. It means that he thought that the fire is a higher rank than the dust, and that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed him, and this is what happened. But when Adam and Eve immediately said, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا and وَإِنَّمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُنَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, they admitted and they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them to the earth, and later we'll show that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the repentance of Adam and Eve. And that's what that we should do. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever. You're going to do wrong things in a way. So, but the best thing, immediately ask for forgiveness. Immediately ask for forgiveness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Do not insist or do not give up. That they say, oh, what we're going to do? This is what happened. And like someone keep on doing wrong things and said, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will welcome you back and will forgive you. Because this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rush to you when you do something wrong and you come back to ask him for forgiveness. Will welcome you, will love you to ask for forgiveness. And look what happened to the nation of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. The Jews, they give Prophet Musa a hard time in all matters. So when Prophet Musa left to seek the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Prophet Musa alayhi salam. And he went in that matter, his people, while he was away from them, they got the gold and what they got from the pharaohs, and they made a statue of a male cow, the calf, and they start worshiping him. And one of them, his name is Samari, did that for them, and they. When Prophet Musa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed him, he came back and told him, what did you do? They said, we just had this gold and we did that, and until you come. We didn't believe that he's going to come back. So Prophet Musa alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And when the people of Bani Israel, they realized that also, they testified that they did wrong. See, ولما سقط في أيديهم ورأوا أنهم قد ضلوا قالوا لئن لم يرحمنا ربنا ويغفر لنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. When they realized that they did wrong, so and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. So again, one more time, even when Prophet Musa alayhi salam took some of them, the best of them, to ask, to supplicate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of them, the 20 people, they died. So Prophet Musa alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and bring them back, because they are the best people of the Bani Israel. And they asked for forgiveness. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them, and they lived, but still, because he was arguing with the Prophet Musa alayhi salam all the time. And this is the reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he asked him to do jihad fi sabilillah, they said, no, go fight by yourself. You go fight, you and your God go fight. Look how unpolite he was talking to the Prophet. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined that they're going to stay in the desert for 40 years, that they are not going to reach their destination that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had for them. So the Prophet Musa alayhi salam asked for forgiveness. فَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَرْحَمْنَا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرَ الْغَافِرِينَ. That's always the end of any situation, that forgiveness that was Prophet Musa was asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive. But still, whatever they did wrong, that when they disobeyed the Prophet, that their destiny was to stay straight in the desert for 40 years, and until the generations passed away and the new generation came when they reached their destination. Also the same was Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to, after the what happened with his people, and one of the Prophet's son was drawn, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Prophet Nuh asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring his son back, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that your son is not from your family, so don't ask for something that you don't know. So Prophet Nuh alayhi salam immediately, Rabbi inni a'udhu bika an as'aluka ma laysa li bihi ilm. He realized that he didn't know the reality. وإلا تغفر لي وترحمني أكون من الخاسرين. Or if you don't forgive me, if you don't have mercy on me, I will be a loser. So this is always, and this is what when realizing that you did something wrong, immediately come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will receive you and they will welcome you back. And inshallah, as I mentioned, this is a very long topic here in the Quran, the verses and the hadith. So in the future khutbah, we'll address more about it. So أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم. Oh Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart and spirit. Oh Allah, do not let our hearts deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي الصلاة حي الفلاة قد تصلى الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله حي الله.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. كافها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا وإني خفت الموالي من ورائي وكانت امرأتي عاقرا فهب لي من لدنك وليا يرثني ويرث من آل يعقوب واجعله رب رضيا يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى لم نجعل له من قبل سميا الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر. وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله. أستغفر الله. أستغفر الله.